Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey and I'm a web designer. This channel, if you haven't already noticed, is all about helping you, the professional designer, professional web designer, to get better at the art, business, and craft of web design, specifically with Editor X. Now, today we're actually going to be talking to Ola Black. She's an award-winning web designer based out of Brisbane, Australia, and she's doing a lot of really cool and impressive work. She's got a lot of good tips to share with us, so I want to jump into that interview. Now, before we do that, make sure you subscribe to the channel and like the video so you don't miss any of these awesome interviews with professionals in our space. We're going to learn a thing or two here today, so without further ado, let's jump in. Hey, Ola, how's it going?
Yeah, I'm good. Thanks. How are you, Brad?
Very good. Thank you. I appreciate you staying up late. It's very early for me. And if I'm getting this right, are you in Australia?
Yeah, in Brisbane. It's 10 p.m. here.
Not 10 p.m. Cool. So it's like 6 in the morning for me. It's early for me, late for you. So I appreciate you staying up late to hang out and chat for a little bit. So let's just kind of jump right into it. Let me know and let everybody kind of watching and listening know. I know. Who are you? What do you do? And just kind of give us a little bit of a background on that.
Yep, sure. So my name is Ola Black. I live and work in Australia, and I'm doing branding and website design with Wix and Editor X. I have been doing it for more than 10 years. So I came to Wix from marketing. I was always doing this kind of things, but when I went online and when I found Wix, I just changed everything and I started building websites for clients exclusively with Wix. And last year, I switched to Editor X.
Cool. And what was it that made you decide to make the switch from Wix to Editor X?
Yeah, because Wix always lack this responsiveness thing and like the pixel perfect website. So it was actually a big step, and I didn't get there from the first effort. So maybe 3 or 4 attempts I had and I failed. It was really very difficult, but yeah, somehow after 3-5 websites, I'm there. I'm confident with the platform right now.
Nice. And when you switched from Wix to Editor X, did you notice like did you change your prices? Did you increase your prices? Did you get different clients, better clients? How did that work?
Yeah. So firstly, no, I kept my pricing the same, just because I needed it. You know, I needed to learn platforms, so I kind of used my clients for that. So I offered them better website for the same price. But after maybe half of a year, I realized that I'm confident with the platform, and it takes much more time, knowledge and all of this to create a website, and the website look like not the same, and I increased my prices. Yes, and now I have I offer like you can have Wix regular website with this price, or like add up this sum and you will have responsive website. And surprisingly, but many clients, they are ready to pay for that.
Cool. That's really neat. And I've seen your work. I've been checking out your portfolio and everything like that. And the websites you're building right now on Editor X look amazing. So like, I'm not surprised that you're increasing your prices on that. If you don't mind me asking, how much would you have charged prior to, and then how much are you charging generally now? I know that you can do bigger end projects and smaller projects, so you can kind of give us a range. But yeah, if you could let us know a little bit about that.
With Wix, I charge something around 4,000, and with Editor X, it's 6,000. So it's like very, very classic. Yeah.
So when you say 4,000, are we talking US dollars, or you charge?
Yeah,
okay,
US.
Cool. Okay. Yeah, no, that's great. That's a really, that's a great price to charge. And what do they get when someone hires you to build an EditorX site? One of your clients comes through the door, metaphorically speaking. What do they get? How does that process look?
Yeah, so if they are very new and they have nothing but, let's say, name idea, I actually like the projects like that when I just jump in the beginning. And I create a brand for them. And by the way, it's not included in this 6,000, obviously.
Okay.
So I create the whole branding, logo and like brand book, style guide. So when we are done with that step, we know approximately where we are going in terms of visual strategy of the brand. So yeah, and then I start building website and I help them to work on their content. So the content strategy, I call it. So yeah, I squeeze information from them. So because many clients, they not share much, like they don't think that some information is important and makes difference. Or some client, they pour like lots of information and I just need to, you know, find what we really need to tell their clients. So I build websites not for my clients, I build websites for their clients. And so this is the process when I'm working with them. I'm asking all these like many questions, and then we have the content ready. I do basic SEO, of course, like it can be advanced, but again, it's just extra things. And then we are launching it. Yes.
Wow. Okay. So I want to dig into a little bit. You were mentioned getting content out of your clients, squeezing it out of your clients. That's a common problem for web designers and freelance, you know, designers who are building sites for their clients. A common problem is like, how do I get content? Do I write the content? What do I say to get the content out of the client? So how do you, you know, get that from the client in such a good way?
Yeah, it is. It is really a problem. And it's funny, like it always, this is the thing what can just pause a project. And whenever a client asks me like how long it will take to create the project, the answer is always, it depends on you, not on me. Like how ready you are with the content. And yes, we do provide copywriting and like SEO based copywriting or just creative copywriting, if they're ready to pay for it. It's not, in my case, it's not a cheap service at all. It's like really another, let's say, 6,000 to create all these things. So many clients, they prefer provide their own content. I start from the first list of questions, then based on their answers, I ask another question. So, but we always keep in a structure, because the structure of the website, it's kind of the first step for me. And I often show them kind of mock-up with the placeholders. So they basically see, so they have to write here these many lines. And so, because I don't want to get the content just, you know, the list of something which I cannot work and make it beautiful on the page. So mm-hmm. Yeah, they have the skeleton to write. Sometimes I say, look, we need like another thing just in terms of visually it will look better, or we need to reduce this because it will be messy. So mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like the process. There is no like, here is content, here is design. It's just going like that.
Yeah. Okay, cool. That's awesome. That's a good tip. So there was something that you were mentioning to me before. You mentioned micro interactions. Could you enlighten me on what that is exactly and how that's something that you're excited about?
Yeah, sure. It's really the part I like in design. It comes to me just like out of nowhere, I think, because I have a talent to think about that too. And I like it because it creates this unique user experience. It's you know, it makes the exploring the website more fun and something when user doesn't expect, and it just happens, and it just happens on hover. It's something, it can be something very small, and of course I don't use it much, not to overwhelm with things happening on the screen. And I try to keep it aligned with the brand, with the tone of the voice of the brand, so it might be a text or image, or it's just like the different angle of an image.
So that, it's like that little bit goes a long way, but it also sounds like there's a lot of big stuff that you do. So, you know, you have these little fine details, the micro interactions, you are very good at extracting and squeezing content out of the client, which is a constant problem for designers and web designers. But you also do, you know, like branding and that brand discovery as a part of your whole process. How does, like, what's your process with that? How do you approach branding with a new client? You know, what's your first step, and, you know, maybe some of the big things that you take care of to go down that journey?
Yeah, it's kind of the same. It's all from squeezing information. I'm just trying to understand what their aim, what they want to change, like what they want to, what image they want to create. Like this kind of boring things, that it's like obvious questions. I think here is what is important, that you have to be kind of brave. That because like I am not taught, I don't have like the branding education. It just, you know, you just offer, and you have this ability to visualize and make it nicely. So you just be brave enough to say that you can do it, and yes, you can do it. And yet they, I usually provide like four different concepts, visual concepts. We start from a small thing, which is just a logo, and yeah, they choose one, or they want to like polish it up a bit, so we just work on it. And once they choose this little thing, based on it you can easily create some like more and more visual elements, icons, like you can match fonts, colors. So it all starts from this small logo. And then you just like what is branding actually is the consistency, right? So you have to create this, you have to standardize.
Yeah, standardize
the whole visual strategy. So they have to use the same visuals across all marketing channels, and that's how a logo becomes brand. So this is the only, there is no success or fail in a logo itself, right? So it's just the consistency of using it.
When a client approaches you, do you usually lead with, I do the whole thing? Like if we're working together, we do branding, we do brand discovery, we do the website, and we do all of this, or do you kind of decide based on the client what you'll offer them? How does that work?
If they have logo, if they have brand, I just ask from them everything. Like I, in any case, I need the style guide. I need to understand where we're going. Like I don't start from nothing. So many clients, they already have the logo and like style guide. So I don't force them using my services, of course, in that case. But yeah, then if they don't have, if they want to work with me, they will need to take the branding services as well. It's like mandatory kind of thing. Yeah. Yes, and then they like to work with me, and they ask me to do more things, and we just build this relationship where they just, whatever they need in marketing, they ask me.
When a client comes to you and you tell them, you know, I build websites within the Editor X platform and framework, like, how do you approach that? Because, you know, everything's all in one. You know, the hosting is there, you know, the website's built there, the marketing is there. How, you know, how do you have that conversation?
Luckily, I don't need to have this conversation because that's my niche. So that's why I named my agency 12 years ago. I named it Wix Pro, and in these 12 years, I didn't have the need to prove someone that Wix is a good thing to go. So yeah, I have all my clients, they came for Wix websites. They were looking for me, and I never, like, of course I had some conversation with someone who are not Wix, and because I have the experience with other platforms and I know, like, all these pros and cons, so I can share it with clients, and but I never force anyone. I just give my opinion and leave them to make their decision.
Very cool. So Ola, what are you working on right now that you'd want to share with people? Is there somewhere that people can go, you know, check out your work or follow you? You know, let us know what we can do to take a next step with you.
Yeah, I will be very happy if you follow me on my Instagram, which is wix.pro. So I share my websites, I mean my portfolio, the latest is all there, not on my websites. And I also try to share some tips and new features of both Wix and EditorX. Yeah, what I'm working at the moment, I'm doing a big website for yachts, like for renting and buying yachts in Turkey. That's quite the big, because like it's with database and coding, stuff like that. What else? I have like about 8 projects, and it's not much. Actually, I used to have like 17, 18 projects at the same time. Now it's
quite
time. Yeah, but with considering that I updated my prices, it was actually a very good idea. So I have less work, but same income.
Yeah. That's the key. It's like, yes, if you're getting so much demand, raise your prices and you'll get a little less demand or much less.
That's where you kind of struggling. You think maybe it's too much, maybe I need to go back, because you have this gap when clients like the drop, and you have to wait a couple months when it will take.
Yes. But then it catches back up, and you get to dedicate yourself more to less projects. Yes. So you get to do better work and you get the same pay or more pay because what you're doing is even more valuable now.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's amazing. That's so cool. Well, Ola, I know it's really late for you, so I respect your time. I really appreciate you coming on the show and sharing your insights about web design and EditorX. And we'll be in touch. We'll make sure to link everything up in the description of the video so that everyone can check out your Instagram and your work. And we'll chat soon.
Yeah, thank you so much, Brad. And you have a wonderful day. I'll go to sleep.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thanks again for watching, friends. I really appreciate your time. Make sure to go follow Ola Black on Instagram to see her latest projects and adventures as a professional web designer. Once again, my name is Brad Hussey, and I'll see you in the next one.